Everybody close your eyes and imagine an 18-month-old child who cannot walk or talk and has recently developed epileptic seizures. Picture the child's mother and father desperate to do whatever they have to do to help their child gain the ability to use their own voice and use their own legs and feet to walk and run. The mother and father listen to doctors, therapists, and educational professionals express that their child will catch up someday. They're just slow. They have nothing to worry about. With time, the family of this child will find a child psychiatrist from St. Louis Children's Hospital named Dr. Bourgeois, who discovers some answers. Between the ages of 18 months old and 3 years old, Dr. Bourgeois discovers a brain tumor on the child's front left temporal lobe. Nobody is 100% sure if the tumor was the cause of the epileptic seizures and cognitive delays, and by operating, there was a 50-50 chance that removing the tumor would help, but putting a child so young through surgery would be super risky. At the age of 3, the child's seizures last about 20 to 30 seconds each. The seizures became more and more frequent, coming as little as a half an hour to an hour apart. The child's family makes the difficult decision to allow the team of doctors to remove the brain tumor at St. Louis Children's Hospital in hopes that the child will live a happy and healthy life. As the entire family waits nearby, fearful of the outcome, the child's brain tumor is removed. After meeting with the neurosurgeon, Dr. T.S. Park brings the child's parents into the ICU to see their bald-headed child. Imagine the child's mother standing over the crib and witnessing her youngest child stand up for the very first time on their own, walk around their crib while singing a song called Mama Paquita. Emotions fills the mother's entire body as she energetically interrupts the father, who is still speaking to the surgeon. When the little one's father walks towards the crib and notices the child singing and walking around, the father happily picks up the child and expresses, "Your dark clouds have gone away and your sunshine has come out to shine." Imagine the hope, faith, love, and support experienced throughout the scariest moment they had ever had as parents. Now everybody, open your eyes. You are maybe wondering where this story came from or how I know this story so well. Believe it or not, this story is my own. This story describes one of the many ways that my family, inclusion, and music saved my life. I shared this piece of my story to explain how I use music to cope with my developmental delays that have never gone away, to express how they lead me to find my passion, which is using music to help each person I work with to overcome everyday challenges and delays. By providing my students with the chance to sing, dance, act, and perform, I am giving them the educational tools they need to become whoever they wish to be in their everyday lives. Whether you are a student in high school, you have a job in a work program, or you are sitting in this room motivated to earn that four-year degree to make a difference in the lives of generations to come, always remember that you and your students can and will achieve whatever they dream with these three tools of family, inclusion, and music. My students and I are proof that having a disability does not mean that we do not have abilities and possibilities in this world. Take me, for example. From the time I was 18 months old until I was 19 years old, I was provided with special education services in and out of school. I was diagnosed with many different types of cognitive delays and had many wonderful and horrific times in school. I knew that quitting was never the answer, and using music as my voice, I found the power to continue. I wanted to give others that power, which brought me to the idea of including others. Rewind my entire life story to about 10 years ago when I was a freshman in high school. I chose to include students who have disabilities by having them perform Shrek in front of an audience, although I had no idea what I was getting myself into. I started to see the confidence building within the students I encountered. Throughout the rehearsals, I had discovered that the student who played Lord Farquaad had a diagnosis of cerebral palsy, autism, vision impairments, and seizures, and yet that never stopped Farquaad from succeeding. Lord Farquaad invited me to his house to practice, stayed after school with him, and even came over to my house to go over the dance and the songs. All Lord Farquaad wanted was a friend to be there for them, and I was honored to be that friend. The day of the play, Lord Farquaad had their moment in the spotlight and was the happiest I had ever seen them before. Right when the show ended, the tall, muscular student who played Shrek picked me up and spun me around in circles while thanking me for providing them with the time of their life. Next in line to talk to me was my Aunt Julie, who was both crying and smiling. I would give the universe for somebody to take the time out of their day to become a friend to Caitlin and encourage her to build the skills to be a leader like you did for these students. Caitlin is not only my cousin, but basically my little sister and best friend who happens to have been diagnosed with an autism spectrum disorder. Ever since that day, full of positive energy, I have had the dream to make sure that people of all ages and abilities are allowed the chance to feel welcome, accepted, and included in their school, job, and in the real world. Throughout high school, I was involved with helping students succeed in their PE class, choir class, academic lab, and after-school activities provided by Stages Performing Arts Academy. Back then, students cheered my name every second they saw me and inspired me to never stop believing in myself and in all the people I work with. After I graduated from high school, I started working at Stages Performing Arts Academy. From the time I walked into the academy on the first day of my job, I knew I had found my new students, new friends, a new family, and a place to call home. Today, I continue to make sure my students' voices are heard through sharing my story in a chapter book I wrote called The Music That Gave Me a Voice. My students appreciate the time they have to show off their talents through this music that continues to help them find their voice. To this day, my students remain my cheering section everywhere I go because of the role they play in my life. Each and every one of my students has a way to show to the world what all they know through the power of family inclusion and music. Singing, dancing, and acting, and performing brings out their personalities, builds confidence, and builds life skills and communication along with the ability to build relationships. Any teacher can benefit through using family inclusion and music to prepare students for success and not failure. My students have gained the ability to share who they are. So now, how about we let them show you all they have to offer?